This is the demonstration of the B-spline surface editor first version. I start with a vector array node which creates a starting surface here. We have here 12 times 15 poles with degree 3. The structure, there's some randomness on it. And next we have here a tracker to define the point where the surface should go through. And I activate the tracker, so okay, I reset it and I start it. And it starts here at this position. And now I can move it. And at the moment it is outside the surface. I go now inside the surface, and at this moment I get a new surface calculated. So when I have a look at the editor, I see here there is a flag display ISO curves. That means these are these two curves which go through this target point. And I also can switch to display the full surface this way, but there are some difficulties. I cannot get this mover handles by the mouse. I only can use this, and so it's sometimes better to have only this display, and so I can move it. And now we see these two curves, and we have a look how we can modify this curve. It's not easy to find a fast algorithm to move to parameterize the curve that it always goes to the maximum here. So I have here the possibility to change the curve a little bit, and this all are possible solutions where the black curve, the ISO curve, goes through this target point, and I have this for the U direction, and I also have it for the y direction the same. So I always can select this parameter this way, that the surface has its maximum in this point too. It's always so difficult to say what is the maximum. If I go in the negative z-axis, it's the minimum. So I use these two scalars in this way here. So okay, we see here the created surface. Next things what I can do, I can now use and make the new surface broader. So I have here offset, and when I change this value, the solution is stretched in U direction. This is always the number of extra poles or segments which are influenced by my algorithms. So I can go here this way, I go back, and I can do the same in the other direction. We see this here. And here too. So then I have a parameter which I use to make this curve sharp or less sharp. So when I use this, I can make it sharper. The same we have here. And we have the impact also if we use less segments. So in this case it does not make sense. I only use one segment, and it does not make sense to do this. So the next thing is I can now say what should be the direction where the point is moved. In this case, I can first say I have a start position, and I display the start position is here. And this start position is defined by these two sliders, so I can move it. And we have the start position, and also we have the target position. The target position is in this case, because of my configuration here, is it the position of the tracker. But it can also be an other point selection from the FreeCAD GUI or something else. And now I can, so I use the start. So in this case, now this red point is tracked in this direction, and with this tracking, the complete surface is moved in this direction, and we see there are some consequences. For example, here I can drag to the left side up. The target always follows the tracker. And I still have the possibility to change my curve this way. So there are some conditions which must be satisfied. We see here, we have here some trouble because it goes outside. So I can now change it this direction. And this method also works with multiple segments. So, okay. The start position is given by the U and V coordinates of the surface, but I also can use, I can say I do not want this one, I want a start position, and so I can add here another tracker. I use this tracker and I start this tracker, and we see it here, this is the other tracker. So, and this other tracker is connected with the start position of my editor. So, here and now I can say I want to use the start position. Oh, so I use the start position, so I click here. And in this case, the start position is here. And I have to calculate once more the solution. So let's reduce all a little bit. So, and we get a new solution. Now this point is tracked or moved in this direction. The surface is tracked in this direction, and I get here the resulting curves, and I can play a little bit with the curves as usual to make it here a maximum. So, and at the end I display the surface this way.